Hey everybody, my name is Chu Gutierrez and welcome to Boss Labs. And today I want to talk about video, and primarily I want to talk to photographers who are thinking about transitioning over to doing video or adding it to their arsenal so they can offer it to their clients or just for personal fun projects. My background is in cinematography and video primarily. I did that since eighth grade basically up until now through college. It's been video, and I want to say maybe the last 4 years I've integrated photography into my business. So I definitely am way more comfortable in the video world, but I do live in this photography world, whether I'm working for brands or other photographers. I shoot a lot of content and BTS stuff for photographers that are on this platform. Miguel Quilas, Manny Ortiz, I've worked with Taylor Jackson, the Photo Brigade here in New York City, Brandy Nicole and Emily Teague. And these are some of my favorite people to work with and create content for, and they do some amazing work. And please go check out their channels and their videos. And on occasion, you may see a few of my clips in some of their work. But as a video shooter and a video editor, working with some other photographers occasionally, none of the ones I've listed here, but you occasionally get footage as an editor from someone who has an SLR or mirrorless camera that has the capability of doing video. And they shoot video and you get them as an editor. And you realize that maybe they weren't as comfortable, you know, on that side of the lens while doing video. So then what happens is the edit tends to suffer a little bit. You know, the footage dictates the edit versus you being in control and directing the final outcome of your piece. So these are like really quick tips that I've kind of put together. Some of them are best practices. Some of them are, just general basic ways of thinking for when you're shooting the video. So let's get started with tip number one, and that is to double your frame rate when it comes to your shutter speed. It's a very easy one. It's gonna give you the most natural looking motion blur when it comes to shooting video. The most natural that looks like it's coming from your eye, doubling your shutter speed when it comes to your frame rate. So what that means is if you're shooting 24 frames a second, make sure your shutter speed is 1/48. And most cameras, that's gonna be 1/50. If you're shooting a little bit faster frame rate, like some slow motion, say you're shooting 60p, 60 frames a second, you're gonna want your shutter speed to be 1/120, just doubling your frame rate. So keep that in mind when you're shooting. It's a general rule of thumb. Of course, like anything else, these can be broken. There's scenarios where you're gonna want a faster shutter speed to get a certain look, but 95% of scenarios, this is gonna work for you. Just double your frame rate when it comes to your shutter speed. So let's move on to the next tip. Tip number two is to hold your shot. And I know this might be really, really simple as far as the concept goes, but shooting photo and doing events and just even portrait work, as a photographer, you wanna shoot frame after frame after frame and move on to the next one. And that mindset sometimes transitions over to shooting video. So what I like to do is, as an editor, when I'm getting footage, I want per clip, I want at least 3 usable seconds that I can use from a clip. That's 1, 2, 3. That's how long I need, and then I can transition into another clip. Bare minimum is 3 seconds of usable footage. So what I like to do when I'm shooting video is I press record, and once if I'm on a tripod, and once I have my shot framed the way I want it, I count to 6. If I'm doing a movement on a gimbal or a Steadicam, I count to 6 at the bare minimum. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then I stop recording. The clip can go longer if need be. If you're capturing something that's happening and you want a longer shot, by all means, shoot longer. But that is the bare minimum that I try to do. It doesn't matter if I'm shooting slow motion or, you know, real time footage. Hold the shot for at least 6 seconds. That's gonna give you a lot of flexibility in post. And especially if you're outsourcing your edits or giving them to someone else to do it, it's gonna be such an easy experience for them, knowing that they don't have to deal with a 1.5 second clip of usable footage for a 3 minute piece. You're gonna notice it moves really fast. And in that case, like I mentioned earlier, your footage is gonna be dictating your edit versus your creative input. Tip number three, I call wide, medium, tight. And this was something that when I was in college working on campus for the video department, one of the shooters who was more of a ENG news gathering kind of guy just drilled into my brain when I was shooting. He was like, just think wide, medium, tight when you're out in the field. So shoot your wide shot, your medium shot, and your tight shot of any given location or subject that you're focusing on. And this is gonna help you get, one, a lot of coverage, And two, it's gonna help you build the sequence of what's happening, right? So every time you're out shooting, doesn't matter what you're doing, if you're shooting someone who's dancing or someone who's fishing by the pond, get a wide shot of the scenario. Zone in on a medium shot and then get a nice close detail shot. You don't have to use these in the edit always, but it is gonna give you a lot of flexibility. And once you're in that tight shot in post, you can jump to any other medium shot or any other tight shot or any other wide shot without the audience feeling kind of confused, right? You're already as close as you can get. Anything after that goes. So this is really just gonna help you thinking in terms of sequences and helping you build coverage for your edit. So let's get into tip number four. Tip number four is stable cameras make for happy footage. And this one's a little tricky. I have nothing against handheld footage for the most part. I don't shoot a lot of it. When you're shooting with the intention of wanting to have a handheld look, I totally get it. It's when you get the jitters or the rolling shutter effect from using a handheld shot with a long lens on some of these stills cameras that you really kind of realize that that probably wasn't the intention when shooting the shot, right? So nothing against handheld footage. If you're going for that look, by all means, go for it. I love it when I see it. But what I'm trying to say is don't use a 135 millimeter lens with no IS or any sort of stabilization handheld and give me jittery footage and expect me to think that that's pleasant to watch, right? So use your tripods, use your gimbals, your stabilizers, put your arm against a wall to get stabilized. There's a bunch of videos on YouTube that show you how to stabilize yourself with your camera straps and find your sweet spot. For example, you know, if I'm shooting handheld, I know myself, I don't like shooting with anything above a 50 millimeter unless I'm using a shoulder mounted cam. My arms just aren't that steady. Some people might be able to shoot with a 100 millimeter, maybe a 135, 200 with no IS because their arms or their hands are just that rock solid. Once you find that area for you, then by all means shoot away and anything above that, stabilize your footage. But I know for me, 50 millimeter and up, I'm gonna want something, a monopod, a tripod, a stabilizer, anything. So that's really gonna help you out. It's gonna help make your footage just look cleaner and just more professional. Plus, if you wanna add some shake, you can always do it in post, right? So let's go to tip number five. Tip number five is to overshoot. And I'm sure you've heard this before, but I'd rather overshoot than undershoot is one of the sayings. And it's 100% true. I know for a fact that you would hate the feeling you get if you're in the editing room and you're finishing up your project and you say, damn, I need 15 more seconds of usable footage. So going back the list, create sequences, get your wide, medium, tight, shoot for at least 6 seconds, and then overshoot. A handful of frames in an edit can turn your edit from good to great when it comes to pacing. So get those extra shots and really kind of help yourself out in post there. So a quick recap of the tips is tip number one is to double your frame rate when it comes to your shutter speed. Tip number two is to hold your shot. So I'd like 3 seconds of usable footage per shot. I usually hold my shot once I start my shot for 6 seconds. Tip number three is wide, medium, tight. Create those sequences. Tip number four is stable cameras make for happy edits. And tip number five is to overshoot. So those are five tips for a photographer who wants to transition over into doing more video work. And we want to see some of your work, especially the ones that are using these tips if you learned anything from this video. So tag us on Instagram if you're posting your work there. Use the hashtag that's right here. I believe it's BossLabsV1 for video number one. And if you're on YouTube, you know, drop links down to your work below. I'd like to take a look and see what y'all are creating. So yeah, that's it for me today. Hopefully this helped and hopefully you can find some use in some of these tips. And we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.